In this video of electrostatics, you are going to learn about electric field for continuous charge distribution. Now, as fancy as the name sounds, it's not that difficult. Remember when we found resultant electric field due to a bunch of charges? Just similar to that, we will now have a continuous charge distribution on objects like a rod or a cylinder, or just about any physical object. Let us first start with the rod. We will find electric field along axis of rod of length L having charge Q. So let us assume a rod of length L having charge Q uniformly distributed over it, and we will find electric field at this point situated at a distance x from it. Before we start with the mathematical part, there are three simple steps for these type of question. The first step is select a tiny element. On the given object, you have to select just one tiny element, then find its E, find the electric field only due to that tiny element, and integrate for the whole body. Mathematically, it may be a little bit different depending on different types of objects. The common problem I face for all my students is they start complaining,
"Why can't I just remember the formula?"
You can remember the formula, you will remember the formula, but this is just to establish how certain formulas exist, and in the examination you may not be given these types of objects directly. You may have a rod, a circle or a sphere, a cylinder, an arc, triangles, rings or frames, or they can just combine this together and tell you to find electric field at the center of this given system. That is why you need to go through the mathematical part of these kinds of derivation. Back to our rod. Now, so first step is to select a tiny element. So we choose this teeny tiny element over here having tiny charge dq, having tiny length dr, situated at a distance of r from our point of interest. Now the next step is to find electric field only due to dq. So electric field due to dq, if we assume positive charge distribution, will be towards the right side, pointing away from the charge, having magnitude dE. So by the definition of electric field, dE will be equals to k dq by r square. Now the final step will be to integrate. Before we go into the integration part, let me first introduce the concept of charge density. Charge density is nothing but charge upon volume. Since here our rod is a one-dimensional object, we will consider its linear charge density, that will be charge upon length. Since we have assumed uniform charge distribution, therefore total charge upon total length will be equals to tiny charge upon tiny length. dq will be equals to q by l into dr. We will use this in the mathematical part of integration. Now, dE is nothing but k dq by r square, that we have already established. Therefore, to find the total electric field due to the entire rod, we integrate from x to x plus l. So, the entire length is considered. Here we have two variables, dq and dr. So, for the sake of simplicity, we will substitute for dq as q by l into dr. Substituting it, we get kq by l as the constant. We remove it from the sign of integration. So we are left with dr by r square. Now you know that integration of 1 upon r square dr is nothing but minus 1 upon r, having limits from x to x plus l in this case. So applying the limits, since there is the minus sign, we will have lower limit minus upper limit. Simplifying it, cancelling L over here, we get the final expression for electric field along the axis of a charged rod E equals to KQ upon X into X plus L. Now, for these kinds of derivation, you have to always cross verify your answer. Now, to cross verify, you have to simplify it back to a point charge. So, L tends to 0 such that X is much greater than L. So, here X plus L can be nearly equals to X. And we will substitute X equals to R as the distance between the two points. And therefore, your final answer must be E equals to KQ by R square. If you can't solve it back to KQ by R square, then you have definitely made a mathematical mistake in the derivation part, or you have made a mistake while assuming for the point charge itself. So that's it for electric field along axis of rod of length L. Tune in next week for more videos.